if you've ever run fast or done a vigorous exercise, you must notice that after some time, you have to stop, you have to take rest. You have to replenish yourself. This fact was well known to nature. It knew that you'll be very busy, it knew that you'll be doing a lot of tasks. To make sure that you do not scrounge on your resting time, it made something called sleep. Everybody, just everybody, has to sleep. We used to do it quite efficiently in olden times because we were like babies. They sleep whenever they need to. But modern man thinks that he can cheat nature. He has so many things to do that he thinks that why should I waste one third of my time in only sleeping? He encroaches upon this time to do some work, and in a way it shows results also, but that can be a disaster in the long term. So we have to look at various aspects of sleeping, how much to sleep, what kind of sleep it should be, and at what time it should be. First of all, we should talk about how much to sleep. Please remember, if too little sleep is bad, too much is also bad. So you have to be within a safe zone. It's very easy to remember. 6 hours sleep is compulsory. 7 hours is ideal. 8 hours is a luxury. And anything more than 8 is an indicator that you're destroying yourself. If you have to sleep for more than 8 hours, that either indicates that you ate something wrong, or it means that you are putting some other kind of burden on your body. So somewhere between 6 and 8 hours is your right period. You decide what works best for you, because when you get up, you should be absolutely refreshed. That can be possible only if you are between this magic figure of 6 and 8. There are yogis and other people who can make do with less than 6 hours of sleep, but then their eating habits and other habits are much different from a common man. For an ordinary person, this is the median, this is where he should be, between 6 and 8. But only the quantity itself doesn't make it proper sleep. How deep your sleep is, how genuine your sleep is also important. Some of us fall asleep, but we are tossing and turning in our bed, or we are dreaming, and mostly very violent kind of dreams. We keep on waking up very often. If that is happening, you will not be rested the next day. The basic purpose of going to sleep would be defeated. We indulge in activities which are designed to spoil our sleep. If you also find that your sleep is not as deep as it should be, then you must take a few precautions. The first thing is that if you are short on nourishment, it will be very difficult to sleep. So you must eat wholesome, healthy food and also not go hungry, which not many people do. Our problem is different. We take foods which rather ruin sleep. If you're taking late tea or late coffee, this will disturb your sleep. So you should be very careful. Similarly, what time you eat your dinner is also very important. If you have it very close to your sleeping time, it will be interfering with your sleep. Your aim should be that you should take your last meal at least 2 hours before your sleep time. Supposing you intend to go to sleep at 11 o'clock, you should not take anything after, say, 9. That may not be very fashionable. Eating early is not considered very fashionable, but it will at least ensure that you have proper rest. More than the food, another problem that is arising for people is that they spend too much of time on electronic equipment like your smartphones, laptops, television. You see, these have got screens. and they are lighted screens, and that light is very sharp. When you keep your eyes focused on them, your mind is fooled into believing that it is not yet sleep time. It thinks it is still daytime. As it is, we are causing this inconvenience to our body. You see, all through history, human beings and other living beings, they go to sleep as soon as the sun goes down. That was the standard practice. Then we invented electricity, and we thought that it is now a license for us to keep awake for as late as possible. The body does not work like that. We were delaying sleep from, say, 7 o'clock or 8 o'clock. We had already shifted it to 9. And even at 9, if we look at our screens, our body thinks that it is daytime. It will not let you sleep properly. So around 9 o'clock, you must say goodbye to your phone and your laptop. That's hard to do, but not sleeping would be even harder thing to do. So cut that out. Similarly, doing something very exciting or reading something very adventurous also interferes with sleep. If at all you have to read something, it should be dull, boring kind of reading that will ensure that your mind is not distracted. Another problem some people face is that they start thinking of the day's problems or what they have to do the next day at bedtime. That also may force you to stay awake. That should be the time when you should think some positive thoughts or have a calculation about what good things happened in your life. Then you will be able to sleep better. So much about the quality of your sleep. But equally important is what time you go to sleep. As I just said, we were supposed to go to sleep very early, but this invention of electricity delayed the whole thing. Even in the previous generation, keeping awake till midnight was a huge achievement sort of thing. The saying was that somebody is burning midnight oil. Only the students studying for an examination used to keep awake till midnight. That was, say, once in a year. But in the present circumstances, we think that it is absolutely necessary to be up till midnight, 1 o'clock or even 2 o'clock, only for going to a party or a club. Unfortunately, your body does not like it one bit. Never be under the impression that you can sleep at any time. Think of it like this. Supposing there's a person who goes to sleep at 10 at night and he sleeps till, say, 5 o'clock. He has slept for 7 hours. There is another person who slept at 12. He was in bed till 7 o'clock. Another one went to sleep at 2 o'clock. He was in bed till 9 o'clock. Now, they may think that they have all spent equal time sleeping, but the person who slept at 2 will not be as healthy as the other people. Your target should be to sleep as early as possible. The worst case scenario should be to be awake till midnight. Ideally, 11 should be nights out, so that by 11:30 you are fast asleep. Some people say that we have difficulty in falling asleep. There are three ways to take care of that. One, if you engage in some vigorous physical activity during the day, it will help you sleep better. Two, deep breathing, especially when you're going to bed, will be again a great help. And if you are trained in meditation, do a bit of meditation. That will also help you sleep better. This little factor itself brings about such rich dividends to you that your life will turn for the better. One more thing, shift workers, those who work night shifts, they are again going against the circadian rhythm. They should try to avoid doing that. Some people have this difficulty, they have no other job to take care of. So in your younger days, if you do it, it's perfectly okay. As you grow older, try to come out of it. See, there have been studies that they found that the incidence of Alzheimer, in which you forget who you are in your old age, was 10 times higher in people who in their younger age were shift workers who slept at wrong hours. So that we must be very careful about. Unless it is absolutely compulsory, don't do it. One more thing. Some people are worried about whether they should sleep during the daytime or not. This is a major concern with many people. You see, we were actually designed to be awake from say 5 a.m. to 7 p.m. Today what we are doing is that we have extended it to almost midnight. Your body needs some rest in between. So, an afternoon nap is very good for you. It's very healthy for you in the present circumstances. The care has to be taken that it should not go beyond half an hour. If you just rest for half an hour, it will be doing you a lot of good. But if you sleep for 2 hours or 3 hours in the afternoon, it will again disturb your sleep at night. The earlier phrase used to be catching 40 winks. Yani, the time taken in closing and opening your eyes 40 times, that was the sleep time. In modern terms, you can say half an hour. Sleep just that much, and then you'll wake up refreshed. If you keep it out, keep your sleeping period for 2 hours in the afternoon, there'll be trouble later. So use this time fully. The ideal situation was to divide your 24 hours into three sections. 8 hours of sleep, 8 hours for your profession, 8 hours for your personal grooming and your family. Unfortunately, we have become so work obsessed that we encroach upon the sleep time also. We encroach upon the family time also. Our family is ignored, our sleep is ignored. Your body does not like it one bit. It hits back and hits back at a time when you least expect it. So when the people say that suddenly I had blood pressure or heart problem, it's not suddenly, it is the result of the mistakes that you make. Keep them separate. Just as you do not take your family into your office, just as you do not take your sleep into your office, do not bring your work to your bedroom. Bedroom is meant for sleeping. If you use that for doing your office work also, your sleep will get disturbed. If it is only for sleeping, the moment you go to your bed, the brain will get a signal that it is time to go to sleep. If you're also doing all your office work there, then the signal will be weakened and you will be in trouble. So, three sections, they all have their own importance. Your family is important, your work is also important, and your sleep is also important. You can increase one of them only at the cost of the other. Please remember, you are not going to be in work all your life. You're going to retire at some stage. At that time, the only thing that will matter is how much time you spend to your family and friends, one, and how much time you spend sleeping. At that time you repent that, oh my God, I ignored my family, or you say that I ignored my sleep, by then it will be too late. Then the damage would be done and diseases would be there. You must notice one thing about the diseases. They keep waiting when to strike. It happens the same thing in the forest. See, when a lion or a tiger is at its prime, no other animal comes anywhere near it. But when it is old or sick, all other hyenas and other animals, they start making circles around it and they keep coming closer, closer and closer. And then one day when they know that it is really weak, they all strike. In exactly the same way, the mistakes that you're making today, you may not have any problem today. Your body is getting weaker every day. And all these diseases are waiting in the wings. They will strike you when you are at your most vulnerable. When you are sick or when you are old, you will find that all hell will break loose. To avoid that, these tiny little things that I'm recommending to you would go a long way in ensuring that you have a healthy life, not only in your youth, but also when you are an old gray man. You should age gracefully. You should not be 60-year-old. You should be 80-year-young. Today, exactly the opposite is happening. Even 40-year-old people are biologically 40 years, but their body is like somebody who is in his 60s, 70s or 80s. Please don't let that happen. Try to reverse the clock in place of speeding up the clock.